shotgun in the present series of Top Quiz. Battle of the Giants tonight, Phil Collins against Midge Ure. Firstly, I didn't mean Battle of the Giants, literally. Let's meet Phil's team, and they are a man who's spending every Monday down at Hammersmith Palais down the road this month, Elvis Costello. And a guy who's very high in both the US singles and albums chart, Huey Lewis. And their team skipper from Genesis, Phil Collins. And trying to beat them will be Midge Ure's team, and they are Nick Lowe. Singer, songwriter, legendary guitarist, that's me, but also John Martyn. And a man coming back for more punishment, his fifth time, from Ultravox, Midge Ure. Right, team round coming up first, meaning you can confer, at least a little bit. We're going to show each team three clips of videos with the wrong soundtrack. I'd like the title and the artist appearing in the video, and also the title and artist on the soundtrack. Lots of points to be scored here. Phil, your team to go first.
I have had to fight almost every night down to the centuries. That is when I say, oh yes, yet again, can you stop the cavalry?
Three clips there, all the totally wrong soundtrack.
The first one, the video was Pirates of the Peace and McCartney.
Mm-hmm.
And the song title, I remember the song title of the...
It's not the cavalry.
By Jennifer,
right? And the second video was David Grant.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know the song.
I don't know.
You don't know the song?
No. But Mother used to say video, but Junior.
It was Mother used to say?
I think so.
Oh, okay. And we had Paul Young.
It's Lovell Turner's part of the video. It's the video I'm... It's your division doing, singing it, and it's a video for it as well.
You get 5 out of 6, because it was five to piece, McCartney. Stop the cavalry, Jonah Lewis. Mommy used to say, Junior, intuition links, come back and stay, Paul Young. Level Terrace Park, your division. So 5 out of 6, well done.
Well done, Al.
Well, it'd be fine as well for Midge on his fifth time back. Here are your three videos. Okay, three videos and three different songs.
Right, the first video was Joe Boxer doing Boxer Beat.
Mm-hmm.
And the track was The Beat doing Mirror in the Bathroom.
Right.
Second video was Tracy Ullman. I'm not quite sure what she was saying. And the track was Kirsty McCall doing The Guy That Looks Down the Chip Shop. What's down the chip shop? My Guy. And the third video was ABC and Poison Arrow, and the track was Big Country and Wonderland.
Okay, well, it's 5 out of 6 for you as well, because it was Joe Boxer's Box the Beat, Mirror in the Bathroom, The Beat. It was Tracy Ullman's They Don't Know About Us, which Kirsty McCall wrote. That was a little link there. Kirsty McCall's This Guy Went Down the Chip Shop, Swears Is Elvis, Poison Arrow, ABC, Wonderland, Big Country. So at the end of the round one, Phil Collins' team has 5, Midge Ure's team 5. Stevens, as we go into round 2, which is an individual round, I'm going to play each of you 3 versions of the same song. I'd like you to tell me the 3 artists. Nick, you're first to go. 3 versions for you of Country Roads.
Almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River.
All my friends there, pulling on those reeds, young and then the mountains, going like a bee.
Country roads, take me home to the place.
Three versions of Country Roads, take me home.
The first one was, I think, was probably John Denver.
Was, yeah.
The second one was Toots and the Maytals.
Mm-hmm.
And the third one was Livy.
It was, Olivia Newton-John.
I think our friends call her Olivia Newton-John.
Olivia Newton-John, 3 out of 3, Nick Lowe. Elvis, for you, we've got 3 versions of Ode to Billy Joe.
June, another sleepy, dusty Delta day. I was out chopping cotton and my brother was sailing hay. And then in a time we stopped and walked back to the house to eat, yeah. And mama hollered at the back door, y'all remember, don't wipe them dirty feet. Today, Billy Joe McAllister jumped off Tallahatchie Bridge.
Ode to Billy Joe, 3 versions.
First one's Bobby Gentry, the original. Second one, I think, is Joe Tex.
It is Joe Tex, well done, yeah.
Last one, it's Loretta Lynn or somebody impersonating her.
It was Billy Joe Spears impersonating on that particular occasion. But 2 out of 3, which is good going. Midge, for you, 3 versions coming up of Purple Haze, All Around My Brain.
Purple haze that's in my brain. Lately things don't seem the same. Acting funny, but I don't know why. Excuse me while I kiss the sky.
Purple haze night coming around. Don't know whether now,
very different to the first version.
Thanks. The first one was Jimi Hendrix.
Mm-hmm.
The second one was Mark Carman.
Right, Costello, yeah.
Third one, I haven't got clues in, like, you know.
Phil, it was a toughie, actually. It was Dion's version.
Oh, Dion, yeah, that was easy.
Yeah, easy on that, yeah. 2 out of 3, well done to Mitch and Phil. 3 versions for you of It's My Party. It's my party, I'll cry if I want to. Happy or?
First one's Dave Stewart.
And Barbara Gaskin.
And Barbara Gaskin, yeah. The second one is Helen Shapiro.
It is Helen Shapiro, yes. How did you get that?
Well, you know, it's my past, really. And Brian Ferry.
And Brian Ferry, absolutely right. 3 out of 3. John, for you, we've got 3 versions of Too Many Rivers to Cross.
For years, and I'm
Three versions are too many for Mr. Joss. You look happy anyway.
Well...
I love the organ impersonation.
It's the religious connotations, you see. We've got two JCs and they're singing hymns. First one is Jimmy Cliff. Second one was Joe Cocker.
No points for impersonation.
And, thank you. And UB40 was the third
one. And UB40, absolutely right, Joe Cocker. And Jimmy Cliff. Last in this round, Huey, you've got three versions of Poison Ivy.
She's pretty as a daisy, but look out, man, she's crazy. She'll really do you in if you let her get under your skin. Poison Ivy, Poison Ivy. Late at night while you're sleeping, Poison Ivy comes to creep it all.
Three scratch versions of Poison Ivy. Did you get any of those?
I think the first one was the Coasters.
Coasters, the original, yeah.
The last one was definitely the Rolling Stones.
It was?
And the second one was the Tuffy, because I never heard in America, but
it's a Tuffy. If you were English, you'd probably have guessed the voice.
How about Manfred Mann?
Manfred Mann? You're American and you guessed the voice. The background. Well, Pine's team 13 makes yours team 13. Going to be one of those neck and neck ones. Round three is a compilation round, a team round. We've edited together 10 songs about kings and queens, Peter. What? I want the artists only. No need to write down the songs, just the artists. 10 of them coming up. We'll ask the team captains for the answers after the clip. And here it comes.
We're all family, world, nobility. We are family.
In every nightclub across the nation.
It was a rainy night, the night the king went down. Everybody was crying, seemed like sadness had surrounded the town.
There's a little black spot.
How many, Phil?
Definite eight, we think, and a ninth possible.
No. Definite eight, maybe nine. Mitch?
Ten, we think we've got.
I think you've got ten. Okay, Phil, do you want to clown with your eight, maybe nine first?
Well, Adam and the Ants.
I'll tell you afterwards whether you're right.
This one we didn't know. Stylistics, we had a guess at.
Okay, go on, I'll tell you afterwards.
Average White Band, Linda Ronstadt. Fifth one we didn't know. Phil Lynott, Police, Queen, UB40, and Neil Sedaka.
Okay, I'll show you in a moment how many you have. Midge, how about you?
Right, we've got Adamant, KC and the Sunshine Band. Third one, I'm not sure about, we're saying Marvin Gaye, I think. Dave Edmonds, Generation X, Phil Lynott, Police, Queen, UB40, Neil Sedaka.
First of all, the answer is Kings of the Wild Frontier, Adamant. The answer is KC and the Sunshine Band, you're right, Queen of Clubs. Average White Band, Queen of My Soul. Dave Edmonds, Queen of Hearts, King Rocker, Generation X, Phil Lynott, King's Call, King of Pain, the Police, Killer Queen, Queen, UB40 and King. And finally, Queen of 64 from Neil Sedaka. So seven to Phil Collins' side and nine to Midge Ure. At the end of round three, the scores are for Collins' team 20, Midge Ure's team 22. On to round four, the lyric round, always popular. Two lines of lyrics from a well-known song. All you have to do is tell me which song the lines are from. Elvis, your first go with this one. When I get off of this mountain, you know where I want to go. Straight down the Mississippi River to the Gulf of Mexico.
The band, Robbie Robertson.
It is the band.
Up
and...
Up on Cripple Creek.
Up on Cripple Creek, no trouble at all. Nick, to you, you passed me by one sunny day. Flashed those big brown eyes. My way and ooh.
Oh, I know that one. That's Hello Mary Lou, Ricky Nelson.
It was number one for Ricky Nelson, Hello Mary Lou. Another 2 points. Phil, where do these lines come from? Early morning, April 4, a shot rings out in the Memphis sky.
It is you too.
And the track is?
Pride.
Pride, absolutely right. 2 points, well done. Right, Midge, some lines for you. Yours are, one day I'm going to write a poem in a letter. One day I'm going to get that faculty together.
I haven't got a clue.
It's this one.
One day I'm going to write a poem in a letter. One day I'm going to get that faculty together.
It's David Bowie and Blue Jean. The current ones are always the most difficult ones to get. Huey, your turn now. Some lyrics for you. He was swinging on the sax with a terrible tune. And I was dancing all over the room.
Don't you know that I danced till a quarter to three? Gary U.S. Bonds.
Gary U.S. Bonds, well done, absolutely right. What a track. I was looking forward to hearing the track there as well. Finally in this round, John, a couple of lines for you. Tell me, where did you go last night? Why don't you, baby, tell me, where did you go last night?
It's Howlin' Wolf.
It is, you're right.
Burnett, and it smokes that lightning.
Oh. The howl you did then was great. It was just like the record. Do another. Give me another one.
Yahoo!
Just like it. Just like Howl and Wolf. 2 points. So at the end of the lyric round, round four, Phil Collins' team 26, Midge Ure's team 26. Right into round five, an individual round. That means no conferring. Clip for each of you, after which I'll ask you a couple of really easy questions. Elvis, you're first to go. Have a look at this clip of Richard Thompson. Okay, Richard Thompson's most famous band was Fairport Convention. Three other members of Fairport Convention in that video. Did you spot them? 1 point for two of them.
Dave Mattox and Simon Nicol.
Right, and also Dave Peck. So you got 1 point. For a further point, can you name two albums that Richard's made, either by himself or with his wife?
Henry the Human Fly.
Henry the Human Fly is one.
And Pull Down Like Silver.
Yeah, and a load of them. You've got them right. 2 points. Well done. And there are a whole stack more, but that's all you needed. 2 points there. Nick, over to you for your clip coming up of Pete Townsend. Point, can you name one of his four solo LPs?
One of his four solo... Yes. Cowboys Have Chinese Eyes.
Yeah, all the best Cowboys Have Chinese Eyes.
That'll do for one.
Empty Glass and Scoop and Who Came First. And the other bit, in January 73, Pete Townsend organised and played in a special concert for a fellow artist who'd been away for, well, at least a couple of years.
When?
73. For a well-known guitarist who'd been off
Eric
the
Eric Clapton.
Eric Clapton is the answer. 2 points, yes. Cap and Phil, for your good old clip of Martha and the Vandellas singing He's a Walking Miracle.
He's a walking miracle. Thank you.
Can you name Martha Reeves' only top 10 hit in Britain?
Yes. Well, yes, probably. I could name a few of her hits, and you could tell me if one of them is a top 10 hit. How about that?
Go to the biggest one.
Nowhere to Run?
Go to the biggest one.
Dancing in the Street.
Yeah, I will tell you the first one, because it was Dancing in the Street.
Okay.
However, you should get the second point, because can you name two other top 30 hits?
Yeah, Nowhere to Run, Jimmy Mack, Heatwave.
Yes. Oh, you know them all,
Quicksand,
really.
Quicksand, You've Been in Love Too Long.
You have 2 points for that. Midge, your turn. The footage of the small faces from Colour Me Pop singing Song of a Baker Man. Okay, Mitch, for 1 point, can you name the individuals in that clip?
Yeah, Stevie Marriott, Ronnie Lane, Kenny Jones, and Ian McLagan.
Ian McLagan on keyboards, yes, for 1 point. For the other point, can you name the band that Stevie Marriott formed after he left Small Faces?
Humble Pie.
Humble Pie is right, 2 points. Okay, Huey, some old footage for you of Otis Redding singing R-E-S-P-E-C-T. Well, sadly, he never lived to see his only top 10 hit, which was...
Dock of the Bay.
Dock of the Bay, yes, for 1 point. And for the other point, can you tell me the hit he recorded with Carla Thomas?
Sure. Otis and Carla Tramp.
Tramp. Watch, call me Tramp. 2 points. Absolutely spot on.
Oh,
really is neck and neck at the moment. John, finally for you, a clip of Cat Stevens.
Feel a change of coming from another side of time, breaking down the walls of silence, lifting shadows from your mind, placing back the missing mirror that before you couldn't find, filling mysteries of emptiness that yesterday left behind. And we all know it's better, and yesterday is the past.
Cat Stevens, as he was then, and seeing changes for from Teaser in the Firecat. Can you name the two hit singles that came from Teaser in the Firecat?
More hymns. Morning Has Broken.
Morning Has Broken.
And Moonshadow.
2 points. Well done. The end of round five, Phil Collins' team 32, and not surprisingly, it's yours team 32. Yeah! The bets are flying now. On to round six, a team round. I'm going to show you three clips, and I want you to name the three artists and the songs and the connection between them. Midge, your team first to go. Three clips, three artists, and the connection.
Thinking, or it would.
man say he'd copy the lyrics on top of the pops with him. Right, what were the artists, what were the tracks, what was the connection?
That was the Stones, first of all, Going to a Go-Go was the track. The third one was Rod Stewart and the Faces and You Wear It Well. The only connection, and the, who the middle guy was, it must have been Ron Wood playing the middle song.
Right.
Because it sounded like his guitar playing. Yeah. What the song was, I don't know, the album I think was a bit more an album to do. So it might have something to do with that. Mm-hmm. And the connection was Ronnie Wood.
Ronnie Wood, yes, his connection, because he was in the Stones and the Faces, and it was him in the middle. So you have 5 points, well done. Well, you're all on now over here, you know. 5 points to get, Phil. Here come your clips. You're nodding. Does that mean you've got them?
Well, we've got something. The first one was Bonnie Tyler. But I don't know the song.
No, I hear the song.
And Todd Rundgren.
Don't try to think too hard about the song.
Todd Rundgren and Utopia.
Yeah.
The second one. And Meatloaf, obviously, the last one.
I thought that was Mike, actually.
And Jim Steinman is, I believe, the link between all three of them.
Well, I can sadly only give you 2 out of 5. It was Will Powers' Kissing with Confidence, the first one. Oh, Will Powers' Kissing with Confidence, Todd Rundgren's last guitar, Meatloaf's Bad Out of Hell, and the link was Todd Rundgren, who co-wrote Kissing with Confidence, as you know, Meatloaf produced it, and was in the middle one us himself.
I'm sorry, guys.
At the end of that round, we have Phil Collins' team with 34, Mitch Ure's team edging in the lead with 37. But Will and Mitch's side still be smiling at the end of the quickfire. Fingers on the buzzers. 2 points for a right answer, 1 point of a throwdown. Whose current album is called Eliminator? Eliminator, Huey.
ZZ Top.
ZZ Top, 2 points. What was the Four Tops' only number one? Yes, Phil there first.
Reach Out, I'll Be There.
Reach Out, I'll Be There. Who had hit with Reach Out and Touch? Reach Out and Touch, Elvis.
Diana Ross
did 2 points. Who's this?
Dearly Beloved.
Huey.
Prince.
It is Prince, yes, and Let's Go Crazy. Whose singles include Come On Everybody, Something Else, and Summertime Blues? Yes, everyone got their buzzers together, Elvis.
Eddie Cochran.
Eddie Cochran is the answer. Just hit Nick there. Boss Guitar, Play Me Like You Play Your Guitar, and Ballad of Paladin were hits for whom? Nick.
Dwayne Eddy.
2 points. Whose current hit is called Love Kills? Yes, Elvis.
It's Freddie Mercury.
Freddie Mercury, 2 points. Whose 74 hit was called Love Hurts? Yes, Midge.
Jim Capaldi.
Jim Capaldi is the right answer. Who had a hit in 63 was Just Like Eddie? Yes, Elvis. Heinz did, 2 points. There's a lot of miming going on. In 81, which lunatics took over the asylum? Which lunatics? Nick?
Fun Boy 3.
Fun Boy 3 for 2 points. Right. Which current chart hit takes its title from a James Dean film? Yes, Midge.
East of Eden.
East of Eden from Big Country. Right, 2 points. Who's this?
When I love, I get like
yes, Nick.
That's the Everly Brothers.
It is the Everly Brothers on the Wings of a Nightingale. 2 points. For a bonus 1 point, who wrote it? Yes, Nick.
Paul McCartney.
Paul McCartney is right. And the final question of the series, on the 14th of November 1952, the first British chart was published. Can you name the first ever number one? Yes, Nick.
The Runaway Train.
It was this familiar track.
Say that you can.
John Martyn.
It's very nearly John Martyn. It's Al Martino, Here in My Heart. Good job there wasn't a pop quiz in November 1952. Right, that is it. The scores at the end of that. Not surprisingly, I knew they would be all along. Phil Collins team 48, Midge Ure's team 48. That's it for the Christmas series. We'll be back with another series next year and also a Christmas special. We'll see you then. We'll leave you tonight with a great performance from the early 70s of The Who down at Shepperton Studios singing Join Together, so you can join in at home. We'll see you at Christmas. Bye-bye.